Abbey Laden.
And I really enjoyed your dance last night. I wonder if you could maybe show some of the syncopated steps.
Sure. It's all improvisational, so I'm not really thinking about what I'm doing when I'm doing it. So things come out in different ways, but I probably did something like... Choose to go exactly with the melody. So, like, if the song goes, play, just play down to the river, play the chorus. Wait. 5, 6, 7. Here's what I'll tell you. I'll do it.
It's quiet. I would love to redo it all. But anyway, just go ahead.
I'll do do it, I'll try to mostly follow the melody, and then I'll do one where I sort of play off the melody.
Okay.
You can do the whole thing again.
Okay, just do a chorus, but prefer to think of it melodically.
Yeah.
So following the rhythm was actually harder.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm rhythmic, but I wanted to go where the melody was going more
yeah.
so.
I think that my first teacher, like Thomas Maupin, that was his thing, is just to try to, you know, be the music, you know, let your
yeah.
music tell your feet what to do. Like, that's what he meant, was following the melody.
Yeah.
That's great.
And I think, you know, it's so ingrained, I don't think about it that much anymore.
Yeah.
It's just, I know the dips and dives of the tunes, and that syncopation that's there with the fiddler or the banjo player is what I want to be accentuating. Not every single time, because sometimes it's nice to be, like, kind of hitting up against it and going.
So here's a question. When you're as advanced as you are and you want to incorporate a new step, how do you
yeah.
do that? Like, it takes... Do you have you ever tried it?
I think as far as like freestyling goes, you kind of develop a style, and then you know you don't, unless you're like really trying to make it something different.
You get all your tools that you need for the rhythms that you want, and then you're pretty
yeah
pretty
yeah.
Set.
But like if I were to do it like a tap jam or something like that, I don't have as many. I think you're good. I probably don't have as many tap skills. I did at one time, and I don't anymore because I'm not doing it as much. But that's sort of a whole other set of tools.
Yeah.
You know, different weight and different parts of your feet you're using. And
yeah, I did that for a while. Take tap clinics, and it was never easy to incorporate into buckdancing because it's so much on the toes and whole.
Yeah, I mean, sometimes I'll do a paddle and roll. So it's really a Tennessee walking step, but it's instead of up. Same step,
yeah,
but you have a little bit of a different feel to it.